not talk about family when family's all that we got. Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you're gonna be with me for the last ride. Hello and welcome to Too Fast, Too Forever. There's all kinds of family. We chose this one. This is episode 32, You Are My Lifespan, Chapter 2. I'm Joey Lewandowski.
I'm Joe 2.
And this is our second chapter in our fan fiction reading, or a reading of fan fiction, You Are My Lifespan, found on fanfiction.net. Go listen to Chapter 1, that we did last lap, but here is Chapter 2. Do you have anything to say before we get going?
Yeah, I want to bring our listeners up to speed. I want to give a little recap of last episode. Dom and Mia have a sister named Ellie.
Eli Toretto. Previously on You Are My Lifespan.
Dom was supposed to take Ellie to get her first car, because she doesn't have a car. She only has motorcycles. She likes to race her motorcycles, but just drive cars. She's disappointed that Dom doesn't remember that he was going to take her to get the car. Letty kind of yells at him. Vince offers to take her to get the car. She wants a GT500, a Mustang GT500. This guy just seems to have a whole slew of them in the back of the shop. She pays 40 grad for one.
Yep.
No, 35 grad. Sorry. Leo, something. Leo's there. They bring it back. Everybody oogles over the car. She meets Brian O'Connor. He's there for two lines. Vince gets all pissed because Brian's there, just because Brian exists. Then they go to the mall where she buys a yin yang necklace because they're going to go to race that night. Johnny Tran, her old boyfriend, might be there. As they're getting to the races, two blondes walk off with Dom. Letty's mad. Before she can react, she gets pulled into the back of the car with tinted windows. And that's where our story begins today. So it's a little tense. Ellie's right now in the back of a car. We don't know whose car it is, what's going on here. But this is where we start.
Second chapter is here now. Let me know what you think.
What the fuck are you doing? Who are you?
I yelled, trying to open the door, only to find it locked.
I thought you would be happy to see me.
I froze at the familiar voice, still able to make me shiver in delight. Slowly I turned to face him, taking him all in. Johnny was still as handsome as the day I fell in love with him. He looked older, but if fitted him. Raising my hand up, I cupped his jaw, smiling when he leaned into my touch.
Johnny?
I whispered. I was having a hard time believing it was really him. He chuckled, placing a hand over mine as he kissed my palm.
Yeah, it's me.
I sprung forward, wrapping my arms around him lightly. I was afraid that if I let go, he would disappear.
God, Ellie, I miss you so much,
he whispered. I buried my face in his neck, inhaling his toxic scent of Hugo Boss and all him, bringing back so many wonderful memories.
I missed you too. Not a day has gone by that I didn't think of you.
Johnny pulled back enough to lock eyes with me.
I'm sorry I left you, but my father, I have no excuse. Please forgive me.
I looked into his eyes, searching for something false, but all I found was love and lust.
I forgave you the moment you said goodbye, Johnny. Besides, I had your cousin give me updates on you every once in a while.
Johnny smirked.
Yes, he told me. I also heard you bought a car.
I laughed.
Yeah, I got it today.
Looking up, I got lost in his eyes once more. Leaning up, I stopped halfway waiting for his move. Luckily, I didn't have to wait long before his lips clammed mine. It was slow and passionate. Releasing a moan, he trusted in his tongue and... Oh, God, okay. Releasing a moan, he trusted his tongue into my mouth, meeting mine swipe for swipe. I wrapped my arms around his neck, pulling him closer to me as he deepened the kiss even more. His hands came to my waist, picking me up, making me release a squeal, which made him smile. Straddling him, I pulled away, hugging him. Closing my eyes, I laid my head on his chest, listening to his heartbeat.
I missed you too much,
I whispered. Johnny kissed the top of my head.
As did I, Elizabeth. I will never, ever leave you again.
Looking up, I claimed his mouth, picking up where I'd left off. Smiling into the kiss, I ran one hand through his hair, giving him a light tug, causing him to groan.
So she clammed and claimed his mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I repeated the action three times before I found myself lying underneath my man. Pulling away, Johnny stared down at me. His hand caressed my face before gripping my chin and kissing me lightly. I ran my thumb over his bottom lip, begging him to kiss me again. I've got to say, for all the blue balls that we got from Sharpay, like, we are in it here.
We're so. In it. They're about to bang. We don't in the back of this car. But this car has tinted. Are they, like, in the driver's seat? Are they in the back? I don't know. I have questions. But, yeah, we're just in it. There's no blue balls here. They're fully clamming mouths. We're on.
I ran my thumb over his bottom lip, begging him to kiss me again with a smirk he did, and I swear to you it gets better every time. Johnny moved his mouth to my chin, jaw stopping at my neck, sucking and biting on my sweet spot, making my moan out loud. While he did that, I traced my hands down his chest, gripping the hem of his black shirt, giving it a tug. Johnny got the hint as he pecked my lips, he slid it off, exposing his well-sculptured body to me. Placing my palms on his chest, I ran them down with my nails, leaving light pink trails in their path. Johnny groaned before taking up his previous position. I knew where we were, and honestly, I could care less, but I didn't want to get caught. Luckily, I wasn't the one who would put a stop to it, but a knock on the window. Johnny groaned as I giggled. Fixing ourselves, he lowered the window. It was his cousin, Lance.
Sorry to interrupt, but Johnny, your race is up next.
Lance said. He really did look sorry for intruding. Johnny nodded.
Thank you, Lance.
Not bothering to raise the window, he leaned over, giving a quick but passionate kiss.
I'll see you later?
I wanted to say yes, but I knew by the time he'd finished, Dom would have made us leave.
I doubt it, but tomorrow, I'm all yours.
That seemed to cheer him up.
Good luck tonight.
Johnny helped me out of the car, giving me a slight smirk.
Don't need it. I don't lose,
was his reply. I rolled my eyes.
Cocky bastard.
I watched as he left, but not before he gave me a wink. Shaking my head, I went in search of the family, unaware of Brian's eyes on me the whole time.
Where have you been?
Letty asked the moment I reached them.
I was checking out some bikes back there.
I jerked my thumb to the direction I had come from. Out of nowhere, Leon appeared next to me. I almost gagged at the smell of alcohol coming off him.
Are you crazy?
We all looked at him as if he's lost it.
That is Tran's crew.
Glancing back, I flinched. How did I not notice them?
You have any idea what would happen if they had recognized you?
I scoffed, only he knew the truth.
They didn't. Besides, we are on neutral grounds.
Leon was starting to piss me off. Pushing his drunken ass, I made a beeline for Letty's car. Leon then grabbed my arm, spinning me around, my back hitting the side of the car as he boxed me between him and the car. Placing a hand on either side of my head, he leans in close.
Back off, Leon!
Out of the corner of my eye, I saw Letty, Vince, and Jesse making their way through the crowd towards us.
I don't care where in this goddamn city we are, Ellie. Stay away from them. You have no idea what Tran is capable of. He is one sick bastard. I'm just looking out for you.
He leaned in even closer into me. I knew where this was headed, and frankly, I was getting scared.
Leon, let me go!
My voice came out with a slight tremble of fear and anger, fear of what he was about to do and anger at how he was talking about Johnny. Suddenly, Leon was pulled away, and a dark figure stood in front of me. It wasn't Johnny or Dom.
You're with one art. You're drunk. It's best if you leave.
The man hissed venom dripping with each word. Lance! Glancing around, I noticed not only Lance, but all of Johnny's crew surrounding me, keeping Leon away from me. Leon glared at him.
This doesn't concern you. You're trying to take advantage of a young girl, make it my problem.
Lance growled. Leon chuckled, turning to that side as if he were about to leave. Instead, he threw a punch. Lance groaned at the impact on the jaw before retaliating.
Stop! Leon! Lance!
I tried going to them, but those around me wouldn't let me get close. Dom appears with the rest of the family, grabbing Lance by the back of his jacket. Dom pulls him away from Leon. Me and Vince help Leon up. Damn, Lance really did a number on him, but by the blood on Lance, I'd say it was a tie.
You have a lot of nerve coming here and attacking my family.
Dom yelled. The others stood behind him, ready for anything that may happen. Lance cleaned the blood from his mouth.
I just stopped him from doing something stupid is all.
Dom just glared at him, not believing a word he was saying. With a roll of my eyes, I stepped forward. If this wasn't so damn serious, I would have laughed at shocked looks they all sported. Man, where's a camera when you need it?
What the hell are you doing with them?
My dear brother demanded. When he made a move to grab me, Lance pulled me back into the safety of the group.
Leon is drunk, Dom, and was bothering me. They came in and stopped him before he did anything.
I explained, watching as Dom's eyes soften. Vince snorted.
Do either of you know who she is?
They all shook their heads, obviously lying.
She's Dom's sister.
Keeping up appearances, they all scattered away from me in fake disgust. Lance fixed his jacket, giving Dom a mocking nod.
See you around, Toretto.
Dom didn't even acknowledge me, keeping his eyes on me.
Are you okay?
I nodded, giving him a small smile.
Yeah, you might want to get Leo home before he passes out.
Nodding, Dom sighed and ordered everyone back to the house. Just as I was about to climb into the car, I spotted Lance and Johnny talking. Lance was holding him back as Johnny looked ready to kill. Making sure no one was paying attention, I whistled loudly, effectively getting my man's attention.
Nobody was paying attention but you whistle? Okay.
His eyes snapped my direction, effortlessly finding mine. Having his attention, I mouthed to him that I was okay. Waiting a bit, I watched Lance release his hold on him, letting me know he was calm. Giving him a quick smile, I climbed into the car, but knowing how Johnny is, this was all but over.
You sure you're okay?
Letty asked. I couldn't help but smile. I love this woman like a sister/mother, always looking out for me.
I'm fine, Letty. Let's just go home.
I said, snuggling into the seat of the car.
Whew. Oh. That's the end of the chapter. That was a riveting fucking chapter.
I don't know what happened in that chapter. Like, we just read it, and I'm not sure I follow the plot, but I know that they made out for a while, and then...
Johnny Tran pulls her into the car.
Yeah.
Her and Johnny Tran are making out. They're, like, about to fuck in the, apparently, the front seat of the car. Johnny Tran's cousin, who's named Lance, must be his name from the movies. I don't remember.
Okay.
Comes over, says, Johnny, it's time for your race.
Yep.
So they had been making out in that car for, like, 3 hours.
I would imagine so.
Right? That's what it seemed like. Clamming, their mouths. They're just making out. As she gets out of the car, Leon is drunk and saw her get out of the car. And he notices that she's around Johnny Tran's people.
Okay.
He very abusively, like, pushes her into the car. She gets upset. Johnny Tran's cousin sees Leon pushing her into the car and is like, yo, don't fuck with this girl. And then they fight about it. Blood everywhere. Dom comes in, kind of breaks it up, and tells Ellie to take Leon home.
Yeah.
She goes home with Letty instead. Yeah.
Because she loves her like a sister slash mother.
Yeah, because she loves her like a sister slash mother.
Come back next lap for chapter 3, which is longer.
It says, this was kind of a quick one.
It's longer than the first chapter, even.
This one was dense. There was a lot of action.
There was.
So we know that they're both at Race Wars. We know Johnny Tran's still alive, and he still loves her. She didn't give him the necklace that she just bought for him.
We got time. We got nothing but time for You Are My Lifespan.
I'm going to take a wild guess that a lot of these things just, like, disappear into the night.
And just as a reminder, we have 29 chapters, so on lap 31, we'll be completed.
But as of now, that's where we are in the story. Next time, I'll give you guys a little recap again. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope Mike did good voices, because we can't hear them until now, so...
For all things You Are My Lifespan and Too Fast, Too Forever, you can go to cageclub.me, facebook.com/cageclub, or at cageclubpod on Twitter and Instagram. Email family@cageclub.me and leave us a review on iTunes and let us know that you love us like a sister slash mother.
Yes.
And we'll read it on the next episode. We'll be back next week for The Fast and the Furious, I believe, unless schedules conflict, with Michael Domenico of the Not Her Again podcast. So go check that podcast out in the meantime. I'm Joey Lewandowski.
I'm Joe, too.
And we have no guests tonight, except that was the voice of Mr. Mike Manzi.
Bring us in with the song. Bring us in with the song. Come on. Bring it in. Bring in the song. I hope it's just playing in the background right now, and you just hear me getting excited for it.
And we'll see you next time on Too Fast. Did we say our names?
Yeah, we did that part already.
All right. And we'll see you next time.
I hope we're just getting like 3 minutes of this song at this point.
And we'll see you next time on Too Fast, Too Forever. You wanted to take, and yes, you never wanted me.